Hello and welcome to Friday Production. Our top story: a serious risk or urban legend? An online game named Blue Whale is becoming the reason of numerous deaths of teenagers across the world, which now seems to hit Lucknow, where a boy's body was found hanging from the ceiling fan at his residence. Directives are being issued to ban the use of smartphones by students in school campuses. Let's head to our correspondent to know more about the situation.
The Blue Whale challenge emerged in 2013 and is believed to be the reason behind the killing of 130 young people. The challenge spread through social media, which meant a number of young people were exposed to its manipulation. According to psychiatrists, people who are grown to this type of games have some psychological issues like anxiety, depression and loneliness.
This age in particular, adolescence, is risky for all the things related to not just Blue Whale challenge. It is related to substance addiction. Their priorities change. You will find that the child who has been good in studies till 6th, 7th of class starts changing his results. They may not be good. His orientation changes. So this age particular is problem. Then in that age, the problem comes up with the three specific things. They are children or adolescents who have poor self-image. That's quite common. Poor self-image comes up because of low confidence. That is majorly because of comparisons. If they are unable to express themselves, their feelings, then that's, they are predisposed for this. Second thing is, as I told, at this age, not only they are feeling the pressure, of biological pressure, I would say, they are also having a choice or a desire to prove themselves, a thrill which they want.
The dire repercussion of playing Blue Whale challenge game had brought forth around 6 cases overall in India wherein the teens have either committed or attempted to suicide. The creator of the game asserts to develop it for the very reason of cleansing society by eradicating biological waste.
इसमें सबसे पहले जो भी आज की डेट में फैमिलीज देख रही हैं, अगर उनके बच्चे अपने मोबाइल रखे हुए हैं तो उस मोबाइल से वो चेक कर सकते हैं कि उनके मोबाइल्स में वो कन्वर्सेशन किस बंदों से कर रहे हैं. आज की डेट में आईटी एक्ट के हिसाब से कोई भी गेम खेलने के लिए किसी को रोका नहीं जा सकता. कोई भी लॉ ऐसा नहीं है आईटी एक्ट के हिसाब से कि हम उसको किसी भी बंदे को गेम खेलने के लिए रोक सकते हैं. हाँ, अगर कोई सुसाइड करता है तो उसमें अमेंडमेंट ऑफ सुसाइड की सेक्शंस आईपीसी के अंतर्गत हम लोग एफआईआर लॉन्च कर सकते हैं.
टेक्निकली इस गेम को हटाना पॉसिबल नहीं है हम लोग इंडियन सर्वर से. इंडियन सर्वर्स पे कहाँ कहाँ पे क्या क्या ये कहाँ किस किस जगह पे ये एपीके फाइल्स डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड हैं, इनको रोकना पकड़ना टेक्निकली पॉसिबल नहीं है. हम लोग ये डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड नेटवर्क पे नहीं है, ये चीज़ सिंगल नेटवर्क से होस्टेड है. जो कनेक्शंस बन रहे हैं सिंगल नेटवर्क से बन रहे हैं, टनियन राउटिंग के थ्रू बन रहे हैं, इसलिए ब्लॉकेज नहीं हो पा रहा है. इसका जो फाइल्स हैं वो इवनली जो है ऑनलाइन मीडिया में डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड हैं, लोग आराम से एपीके डाउनलोड कर पा रहे हैं उसका. और जो एडमिन है वो टनियन राउटिंग के बैकएंड पे बैठा हुआ है, इसलिए उसे पकड़ना मुश्किल हो रहा है इस समय.
द कैपिटल सिटी ऑफ उत्तर प्रदेश लखनऊ कुड नॉट रेजिस्ट टू बी इनवर्सली अफेक्टेड बाय द डीमेरिट ऑफ द फैनाटिसिज्म व्हेन इंदिरा नगर रेसिडेंट आदित्य कमिटेड सुसाइड. इन येट अनदर केस, three class 9 students went missing while all three of them were playing the challenge.
Blue Whale game is a disaster, and I feel ki it has, I mean, it's an unnecessary thing which has cropped up into the society these days, and we as schools, we have taken a lot of measures to stop this. It's absolutely a big NO for the mobile. So in school it is not possible. We have warned the parents, we have sent WhatsApp, because we have all the WhatsApp group messages. So we have sent the parents, we have sent in what are the dangerous things, how we have to look after the children, when, how can we monitor the children while they are using the mobiles.
India ranks number one for the highest Blue Whale related searches worldwide. An awareness video has been issued so that people can understand the agenda of Blue Whale game. Our government authorities has been told to keep random check on students and counsel them. With camera person Shristi, this is Swati for Friday Production.
Just after the Supreme Court declared the practice of instant triple talaq as illegal, the All India Muslim Person Law Board in its meeting in Bhopal once again accused the government of attempting an attack on Muslim person laws and welcomed the court order for not going in that direction. The executive committee of the board did not file a review petition as expected, but agreed to set up a panel to examine the judgment. On the contrary, Several Muslim organizations, including Jamiat Ulama-e-Hind, among the oldest in the country, had objected to this ruling. Now let's have a look at this report.
After the judgment passed by Supreme Court on 22nd of August, declaring instant triple talaq as illegal, several Muslim organizations, including Jamiat Ulama-e-Hind, had objected to this decision, saying that instant triple talaq should continue and be recognized as a legitimate divorce among Muslims, even if that meant courting punishments as per the law of the land. It was the first meeting of the All India Muslim Personal Law Board since the Supreme Court's judgment declaring triple talaq as illegal and void. The board, in a statement, registered its displeasure against the decision, saying it would not like any interference from the outsider in their personal laws. The board insiders also stated that the matter of a review petition was discussed in informal deliberations and there were chances that the court then might want to examine other practices such as polygamy and nikah halala, which is why the review petition never came up in the formal discussions. How to implement it would be a headache of the court and the government.
Ye Supreme Court ka mauqif hai. Haan, albatta ye hai ki 6 mahine ke liye uske upar pabandi hai, jo agar dega to uske upar jurmana ya koi saza bhi ho sakti hai. Ab rahi uske radde amal mein Jamiat Ulamae Hind sirf ek hi tanzeem nahi hai, balki bahut sari tanzeemein hain jisme ek tanzeem Raza Academy hai, Sunni Jamiatul Ulama hai, और फिर जमीयत उलमाए हिंद है, ऑल इंडिया मुस्लिम पर्सनल बोर्ड है. सारी तंजीम एक बात पर मुत्तफिक है कि जो हमारा ला और कानून है, चाहे वो कुरान के अतबार से हो, हदीस के अतबार से हो, वही हमारे लिए अटल है. अब अगर कोई इसके अंदर तब्दीली करता है तो गोया कि मुस्लिम लॉ पर ज्यादती है.
नमाज बख्शवाने गए थे और रोजे गले पड़ गए. अ सेइंग इन उर्दू व्हिच क्लियरली रिफ्लेक्ट्स द डिलेमा फेस्ड बाय ऑल इंडिया मुस्लिम पर्सनल लॉ बोर्ड. It remains to be seen whether a review petition will be filed by the board or the board will remain on its stand of letting the government handle the implementation of this order of instant triple talaq. With camera person Shubham Dubey, Yashi Garg, Friday Productions.
Moving on to our next segment, on the 67th birthday of Prime Minister Narendra Modi, reporter Nabonita Acharya traces him back to the times from when it all began and brings you a timeline of his interesting political journey that got him to where he stands today.
On the 17th of September 1950, amidst nobody's wildest of imaginations, a world leader in the disguise of an ordinary human being had been conceived. Like every other remarkable personality, Narendra Damodar Das Modi too had humble beginnings in life to begin with. Far from the sight of a silver spoon, he sure handled the lowest of the variety to churn barrels of tea trying to win bread for his family. At the tender age of 8, with thoughts of bettering the society already brewing, Modi spent most of his childhood as a Bal Swayam Sevak. The transition, though, had to wait a little longer, as a mere 18-year-old Modi found himself taking marriage vows. A decision he soon abandoned, so as to never be able to abandon serving the nation. In the year 1987, Modi joined the Bharatiya Janata Party, and within a short span of a fruitful political career, he in 2001 recognized himself as Chief Minister of Gujarat, a much coveted turning point in his life, as one would recall. During this period, his Gujarat government also had to face substantial criticism over certain volatile judgments taken during the Gujarat riots. However, over 4 tenures, as Modi only remained far from being rejected by the people of Gujarat, little did he know that in the celebratory year of 2014, the nation would elect him to becoming the 15th glorious Prime Minister of a magnificent India. An India that later saw some magnificent changes too under his awarding leadership. The Swachh Bharat Abhiyan drive, the Make in India concept, the much raved about demonetization drive, and the final GST regime are among the very few groundbreaking initiatives that Narendra Modi put forth in the last 3 years of his candidature. And rest assured, there is no stopping him.
That's it for now. For more updates, stay tuned to Friday Productions.